Hi, I'm Sarah Malec, an 8th grade science teacher from Southern California. Thank you for being a pen pal. You have the upper hand. You are way cooler than us teachers, and your pen pals are excited to read your letters and learn about what you do. However, sometimes they might get intimidated or give up if they struggle to read what you've written. This past school year, we had about 13% of students say they had a difficult time reading and understanding their letters. So, here are a few ways that you can write easy-to-read and engaging letters for your pre-scientists. Your pre-scientist has to be able to read your letter. Please check to see that your handwriting is neat and in print. No cursive, please. You might be surprised, but most of our students can't read cursive. And as a teacher, it can get overwhelming when we have a group of students come up and ask us to read their letters to them. You can also type your letter with a size 12 or larger font. Please include clear page breaks and paragraphs when you change topics. For many of our students, this is the first time they have ever received a letter, and they serve as models for what their letter should look like for them. We also want to make sure that students can understand the content of your letters. Our pre-scientists can understand complex ideas and are beginning to understand abstract ideas as well. Please don't dumb things down for them, but make sure that you're using kid-friendly language. If you use specific science words, make sure to explain what it means. Use pictures, drawings, models, doodles. Make sure to add captions to help explain these concepts in your letters. Use metaphors or comparisons to everyday things to help explain complex ideas, like how chemistry relates to baking or how physics relates to car crashes. For example, in my class, I love to explain inertia using what they know about riding in cars and how seatbelts keep them safe. Giving our students concrete examples, kid-friendly definitions, and models and pictures will help make your letter easier for them to understand and engage with. Please encourage students to continue learning by adding links to at-home activities, labs, articles, and even online games. Middle schoolers love talking about themselves, don't we all? Please show genuine interest in their ideas, questions, and hobbies, and you will open authentic communication. Google what they say they like if you've never heard of it. I have to do it a lot too. These past few years have been a lesson in new interests and slang for me to learn. I now understand what it means when something is giving and what Riz is. Don't be offended if the students ask you personal questions. They ask because they are genuinely curious, interested, and they're also brutally honest. They also love learning personal things about you. For example, your pets, where you've traveled, and if you have any kids. Feel free not to answer any questions if they ever make you feel uncomfortable. And please, if a student ever shares something that is concerning to you, reach out to the LPS staff who will contact their teachers to make sure that we get our students all the support that they need. Our four favorite days of the year are letter opening days. Students are always asking when they get to open their next letter. Please always try to mail a physical letter as well as upload a picture to the mailbox. It might seem like such a small thing, but when students only ever get electronic letters and nothing to open, it can really take them out of the excitement of letter opening day. They lose interest and they feel left out. We understand that sometimes letters get lost or delayed, but the sheer excitement of opening a real letter can't be replaced. In class, students get time to read their letter and complete activities related to and using them, such as learning about your career, where you went to school, and how to overcome obstacles. We also use these letters to teach our students about writing techniques to help strengthen their writing skills. In addition, we use your letters to teach our students geography as they research where their STEM pen pals have lived and traveled. Please keep these things in mind to make sure that your pen pal can read your letters, understand what you write, and can relate to you. Throughout the year, you can check out the LPS website and the LPS mailbox for more on best practices. You will use the LPS mailbox to find updates on the program, resources, and links to different blog posts that can be useful for you to review before writing your letters. You can find the link to the mailbox in the description, as well as links to some LPS resources that you can use to help you write your letters to your pre-scientists. We are so excited for our students to meet you. Thank you, and have a wonderful year with your pre-scientists.